in Toronto, the Toronto Star newspaper has published a story about a person who is training young people to put more pages on Wikipedia about women and minorities because somehow they're not getting the credit and attention they deserve by the, you know, graffiti wall of the internet.
This really tickled my fancy, Corey, when I logged on to Twitter this morning and I saw trending in front of me an article and comments about how terrible it is that the editors at Wikipedia are 87% male. And the thing about Wikipedia, of course, is that it is a volunteer website. You know, most people who edit for Wikipedia, they don't get paid. They're not sort of technically employed by the company. And if they do get paid, it is from third parties. Now, generally, when it comes to, you know, getting more people into organizations or professions to make it more diverse or representative, it's things like STEM fields, for instance, you know, which are very prestigious and very highly paid. But Wikipedia, for goodness sake, that's the site that our teachers told us specifically not to reference in essays because the information on it is often so contentious and so poorly sourced. So and if they really want to worry about diversity at Wikipedia, Corey, I looked up the average age demographic of those editors from Wikipedia's own sources. About 27% of the editors are below the age of 21, and the average age of editors in total is 26. And nothing against under 21-year-olds or 26-year-olds, but I think as an information website, perhaps they should be pulling in some sage, wise people to edit these articles and to put forward this information. I mean, where are the 50 and 60-plus editors is what I would be asking. But look, very silly, imagine being so privileged that the biggest thing you have to worry about is the fact that not enough ladies are on Wikipedia editing.
Yeah. Daisy, eventually these you know, social justice warriors will consume themselves. But speaking of consuming, we've got a minute or so where Jill Biden apparently impersonated someone else, which would be cultural appropriation, a trolley dolly on Air Force One, and walked down giving everybody, pretending to be a hostess, giving everybody ice creams. Now, I perfectly understand how she fooled the guy claiming to be president, but how did she fool the Secret Service people and all those journalists? Didn't they see through her terrible disguise, which apparently included fishnets and little booties?
Oh, yes, that was interesting seeing Jill Biden trending on Twitter, mainly for her stockings. I mean, there were people deriding her outfit, of course, but lots of people defending it. But what I took issue with was the fact that people were putting up photos of Melania when she was a swimsuit model, as if to sort of, you know, decry the fact that people were criticising Jill Biden when, look how terribly Melania used to dress. But I'm sorry, that's a total false equivalence. And again, what we were talking about before, about women tearing down other women because they have the wrong political affiliation.
Yeah, it's exactly right. Daisy Cousens, I love your insights and thanks for joining me tonight. I really appreciate it.